see how to eliminate left factoring from the given grammar. So what is left factoring? If grammar contains productions of this form, A derives alpha beta 1 or alpha beta 2 and so on, gamma 1 or gamma 2 and so on, then that is called as left factoring. Okay, so these type of productions, they should be converted, this production should be converted into this form. A derives alpha A dash or gamma 1 or gamma 2, A dash derives beta 1 or beta 2 and so on. Okay, so first check whether the given, so we'll solve this problem, this left factoring with the help of these problems. So first, if you take this first example, check whether this is in the form of A derives alpha 1 beta 1 and so on. So here, so B is taken as A and here this is alpha, alpha, alpha. Okay, so all of them are small b's, so they should be taken as alpha and leftover part is beta 1. Here beta 1, here this b is beta 2. Okay, there is nothing after this, so you can leave it like this. So this is in the form of A derives alpha beta 1 or alpha beta 2 or alpha. Here this is not gamma because alpha is already b. Since we have b here, it should be taken as alpha only but not gamma. If this symbol is different, then that should be taken as gamma. So similarly, second case, here this is A, A derives alpha, alpha. So similar elements in both the places, so they should be taken as alpha and here beta 1, there is no beta 2. Okay, so you can leave it like that. So let us solve this example. So you need to convert these two productions into this form. So first, take B derives. So it should be B derives alpha A dash. What is alpha? Small b. A dash means B dash. Or gamma 1 or gamma 2. So there is no gamma here, so don't write anything. Now take the second production, that is B dash derives beta 1 or beta 2. Beta 1 is capital B, beta 2 is B. So this is the solution for first production. This is a solution for this one. Now we'll solve this. Again, this production is in the form A derives alpha beta 1 or alpha. So this should be written as, written in these two forms. So A is nothing but E. So E derives alpha means small e, capital A dash. A dash means E dash or gamma. There is no gamma again. Here both the symbols are, the symbol is same. So you need to take it as alpha only. So we got only one production. So one symbol here. Next, A dash means E dash. It derives beta 1 or beta 2. Beta 1 is E. There is no beta 2. So this is the production for this second production. This is the new form. Now let us solve the second example. So I am solving this here. See, check whether this is in, this is having left recursion or not. So take it, A derives alpha beta 1 alpha beta 2. Here symbol is different, so this should not be alpha. Now it should be taken as gamma 1. Now check the second one. So here this is not in the form of this left factoring. So this production is not having left factoring. So no need to solve anything for this. So let us write new productions for this one. So A derives alpha A dash. Here A means E. A derives alpha is E. A dash means E dash. Or gamma 1 is C. Next, second production is A dash. So E dash derives beta 1. What is beta 1? Plus E. Or beta 2. Beta 2 means star E. Okay, there is no beta 3. So this is the final production or final grammar for this one. The new productions obtained for this.